Oh man, this is gonna be a tough game. The Bucks have an 85 overall. We're gonna come out with yellow pants. This is gonna be an away game. It's gonna be a tough matchup. Don't know how we're gonna handle these Bucks, man. But we're gonna get it done. We're always gonna get it done. We're kicking off, man. The Bucks are going to start off with the ball first. I thought the 10-minute quarters were too long, but the 10-minute quarters seemed to be just fine last round. We got pretty decent yardage, realistic yardage. Maybe a little bit too much. Maybe we should drop it to 8 minutes because it seems like oh, Bryson Hopkins with a freaking huge hit stick on someone, but they still get the 26-yard line because we weren't able to stop them. They do gain an extra yard. Don't know what kind of cover I want to come out with. We're going to just cover zone because Tom Brady could just fire the ball everywhere. We're going to try to get pressure with Aaron Donald maybe. Oh, that's a really bad play by us. Oh, that's going to be a huge hit by Jalen Ramsey on LeSean McCoy. He does pick up 6 yards. I don't know how to play that first down pickup because Brady does. We got Gronk and Terrell Burgess in coverage on Gronk. We're just going to try to bring some pressure with Leonard Floyd maybe. And that's going to be incomplete. The Pro Bowler Chris Godwin, the intended receiver. Third down. We're going to drop in the zone here. They love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion. We're going to double up on him, and we're going to get a sack from Ebukam. That was very nice coverage there. That was a very nice coverage sack. Samson Ebukam comes off, and he does get his fifth sack. We're going to try to come up and get a block here with Taylor Rapp again. They said they brought this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town. Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can... It's in the Webster, shakes the juke, but Troy Hill is unable to really do anything about it. And we're going to just, you know me, I'm going to go with this counter run play. We got, maybe we should be running the other way because they do got some decent linebackers that probably can read plays very well. But we do get a huge hole up the middle, and Cam Akers is going to squeeze it up and pick up 15 yards on the first play of the game. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well. And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason. I'm going to come up and try to get Cooper Kupp hitting on this slot route. Robert Woods looks like he may have one safety worried about up top. Bringing pressure a little bit, and that's going to be batted down. That pressure came in quick. One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. We are going to come out shotgun here. But don't expect them to back away from attacking. Looks like they're playing everything very well here. We may have had Cooper Kupp, but he was in double coverage. Van Jefferson doesn't break anything. Oh, man. They have really good defense. They're 3rd and 10. They're probably going to come out with a 6 DB set, man. We're screwed. We are screwed here, man. Cooper Kupp, maybe? And he does beat him. Very nice. Oh, my Jesus. Cooper Kupp comes in clutch. He has 1,000 yards this season already. That's kind of fake. We probably should stop using him so much. To feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle the quarterback just says, oh man, that was just a crazy run there. I mean a crazy pass there, man. We're up to the 22-yard line. Maybe try to run the ball here. Don't pick up too much, but we'll take the pickup there. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 23 carries, 132 yards, and a touchdown. Well, this is where it becomes a challenge for the offensive coordinator. He's got a bell cow. I forgot we got Bryson Hopkins on this, man. I don't like this look because Bryson Hopkins is running the route, and he's like a 66 overall. We're going to go off play fake to Cam Akers and just drop it off, and we left him out for a big hit because we just didn't really have anything, honestly. We're going to try to run this curl here. We got Van Jefferson on the stop route. Maybe he can pick up a first down. We're going to watch this coverage. This is our game plan play we've been working on in practice. So
Can we fit that in? It's going to be denied. We're just going to have to go for the field goal, the 3 points here. The secondary is playing very well. We may swing that too much to the left. We do push it in. Very nice.
In the end, the opening drive, Charles, does yield points. Maybe not the touchdown that they wanted.
We do get 3 points on the board, which is better than nothing. Can't really complain, man. Is he going to bring that out? He is going to bring that out. Micah Kaiser's coming off the side. And that's going to be a huge hit from Micah Kaiser. I was expecting a fumble there.
Tampa Bay, they're getting ready to set up shop here for their second
drive. We're calling a blitz here.
The first drive, 3 and out. I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game.
Oh, and that's going to be a nice hit from Taylor Rapp after he picks up 10 yards. It was a zone blitz. Don't get all cocky, man. He's coming out empty set here. We need to get an audible out. We need to get an audible out. Tampa 2 real quick. I don't like this. Pulling back into zone coverage here. Ah, man, I tried to lurk with that ball and try to get the pick there, but we weren't able to pick off Brady there.
Many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. The slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running style.
Very nice tackle there from Terrell Burgess. They're going to be third in inches here. We may just call the house on the blitz.
Certainly something to watch here with the Bucs in 2020.
We're gonna sell on the run here. Bring all these guys up.
Passes coming into 2020. Gronk 78.
And we do get there and stop him.
Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped.
If he had the one with the pass option, he would have had someone open because we sold on the run there completely.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for. One of the best in the league.
I really want to try to get this block off, man, but it's 4th and 2. We're going to go for the squeeze block again with Taylor Rapp. I want to see a block punt this season, man. It's not going to happen. And that's going to go into the end zone. Very nice punt that goes into the end zone for us.
That scoots all the way into the end zone now for a touchback. Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers.
Let's try to get Cam Akers going with this counter play again.
We'll see if he can duplicate the numbers on your screen that he put up last week, up over 100 and a touchdown.
Just going to go right up the middle there because our left hole closed up really quick. We do pick up 4 yards.
Piece in the last game. You know, they're able to throw it pretty well. He ran it exceptionally, and he hoped to continue that same.
I'm just going
to
run this play action. I don't like this look with these cross routes. Well, hopefully we can get someone open, though.
Play action to Akers. Here's Goff.
We're going to have to throw that away. Jesus Christ, their DBs are playing such a good game here, man. We might have to just pound the run. We might have to pound the ball with the run. I'm going to have to go play action again on third down. We may have to punt the ball, man, if we don't get a completion here. Just going to toss it to Cam Akers. Pick it up. Cam Akers, very nice. We'll take it, man. We take anything we can get there. Because their DBs are playing some good defense, man. I'm not liking this matchup here. Cooper Kupp to the outside. Oh, wow. Gets a user juke off and sends a guy flying out of bounds. Goff is starting off bad, but it's okay. We think we can pick it up. We're going to go with the little jet pass here. Hopefully, Tyler Higbee can pick up this block. His running blocking hasn't been the greatest. But off the touch pass. And Cooper Kupp is going to break to the outside for huge yards. Sheds a man off. That was a very nice play there. That counts as a pass.
Sometimes the simple stuff causes the most problems for a defense because there's a breakdown in communication there. When that receiver goes behind the line of scrimmage and it looks like he's going in motion.
We're going to go try to test the out. Oh, they may be bringing a run blitz. We may just try to test the outside anyway. See if we can get it off. We do get to the outside with Cam Akers. He has one man to beat. Spin move. Very nice. Cam Akers has that that spin move there, man. His upgraded spin move. That was a very nice carry there.
run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing.
That was a very nice carry for Cam Akers, man. That was a very nice run here. We're going to go back on the ground with Cam Akers, and we're going to get it into the end zone for a touchdown.
Touchdown Rams. Cam Akers with his 16th touchdown of the year.
16 touchdowns on the season. I don't know if that's too many touchdowns, because Goff is just not getting passing touchdowns. Not going to lie, we're just not getting the passing touchdowns we should be.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive.
That was a very nice drive put together there.
That running backs and quarterbacks give them big.
We tested that outside on that run, man, and it worked out very well because
the consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks.
Bring it down to the 24-yard line. We're going to come back out on defense, and hopefully we can stop them. I don't know if I want to bring pressure. I don't know if they'll be running the ball here. We may bring the front safety up on a blitz, though. We're going to bring Taylor Rapp in on a blitz. Oh, and they find it up top. They find it up top because we brought the blitz up. That was a very nice play there from Tom Brady and Chris Godwin. Very nice reception.
After the catch, gonna net him 23.
I'm really expecting them to run the ball here. Not even gonna lie. I'm not gonna run commit, but I am gonna try to get a hit with with Troy Reader or Micah Kizer or someone. And that's gonna be stopped in the backfield. Michael Brocker's with the stop in the backfield. Pop out zone coverage. Aaron Donald is heating up. Let's try to get a user lurk and interception here with Troy Reader.
Here's Brady to throw.
They go screen. We weren't ready for it. We were not ready for it.
Just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Give him six on the screen, but now it's third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening.
Taylor Rapp is coming up to play this zone, but I don't like it. Ah! I tried to get there with Kizer, but he's not fast enough. He just was not fast enough. I seen that route developing, and I was just like, oh, man, Kizer is not fast enough to break that. And that was a very nice reception there. That is all we can say was that was a very nice reception. We're going to try to get pressure with Aaron Donald. See if that would work. And Aaron Donald gets home with the sack. Very nice. That is what we needed. That's going to be his 10th sack on the season.
Time they've gotten to Brady, and you've got to do it a variety of ways.
We are bringing in pressure. We're going to bull rush with Aaron Donald again.
But in this case, they
looks like they're going to double him up.
That doesn't happen very often.
It's a rarity. He's just such a veteran. His pocket presence so good. But hey,
John Johnson misses with the hit stick, but everyone else gets there. We had a lot of extra coverage, so we kind of just risked it. We're going to go fall back into zone coverage again here. I'm just going
to
play Kizer and see if anyone can get home.
Oh,
Kizer misses with the dive, and luckily Troy Reader was there. But we do get the fourth down stop, and it looks like they may have to kick a field goal here, and they do go for the field goal. Fourth and four in our territory. Surprised they weren't as aggressive because they did make some plays. And that's going to be a good kick. That was a little bit of a risky kick. So leading by seven coming into the second quarter. It took a lot of time off the clock, but they played a very good offense there. I can't even... couldn't figure out, oh man, nothing's working there. Can't even get to the 25-yard line. Henderson hasn't been as good on the return as I would like.
Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. It may just be the second quarter, but he's in a zone well on his way to eclipsing that 100-yard mark.
And when a back has a game, as we're witnessing right now, his name's going to be in the
box. We got him playing on the opposite end, so this may be a good call here. Oh man, we should have waited for those blocks to develop because we may have been able to bounce it to the outside. But we were only able to pick up a couple yards there. I may try to fool him with play action here, even though we've been running a lot of play action. Just gotta just stay away from that outside linebacker, man. He's scary, man. He's very scary. Have you got anybody open? No, we don't. We're just gonna run with Goff. Slide out of bounds. I think that was a first down pickup. Third and inches.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down.
I'm telling you, man, their DBs are playing really good coverage. I don't want to throw any picks with Goff because we've just had too many errors. We've got a huge lane from Cam Akers to the outside. Those user spins work, man. That's his move right there. He's averaging 10 yards a carry right now. Cam Akers is having a huge game. I think we just need to keep running the ball with Cam Akers because that's what's working right now. Our pass game is not working. Our play action isn't working. Let's keep the ball on the ground here. Unable to get away.
Establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground.
We're going to run a drag curl with here. This is our gameplay plan, I guess. Look for someone. We got Cam Akers running the... What the hell? That is a crazy route from Cam Akers. Oh, Robert Woods. You got to get there, Robert Woods.
Yeah, they get to him after a gain of six to the 46.
Third and one. We're going to come up with a mesh play here, and hopefully we can get someone running across, man. This is a big third down here. Take the check down to Tyler Higbee, and he gets it. Very nice. That was just a quick play to Tyler Higbee, man. Goff is 7-11. That's not bad.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him.
I'm just going to dive up the middle with Cam Akers.
And flip the down marker back to one.
They'll run on first down. Akers. And he's going to get a solid gain of nine before being...
Very nice rushing tonight, man. I don't know what's... maybe their run defense is what's lacking. That's kind of why I just keep attacking with the run, man.
We're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They keep covering my play action crosses. They're really good at covering those. So I may need to call like a boot. I'm going to try this play action double cross here. I don't like that DB set, dude. It's like they know we're running play action on cheap. Throw it away. Oh, no. That's going to be a fumble. And they're not even letting... What the hell? They're not even letting me chase him. That was terrible. They made my character just run out of bounds. That was a terrible... I should have just took the sack there. Man, Goff with the fumble. That pressure came in quick.
That's not just a short shuttle now. He took it and went a pretty good distance, didn't he? Did you get the 40 time on that?
That was a very nice forced fumble there. Wasn't what we were looking for coming out of play action there, man. See, their defense is playing well. They're not playing the run well, but they're playing the play action in the pass game very well, and their pass rush is just getting to us. Henderson just can't spin. We're just going to have to keep pounding on the ground, man, because that's what's working for us. It's like, we're tied up, and they haven't even gotten not nearly as many yards as we have. They were prepared for that counter run. They played it very well that time. That's why I can't call it all the time, but... I mean, you can call it sometimes, you know. I don't know if they're calling a blitz here or just a press, but we're just going to play it out and see what happens. We do get Cooper Kupp running the ball, small route. Almost gets the first down. We're going to come out third and one.
You don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
I'm going to try to keep this drive going and just go with an inside handoff because, yeah.
The Rams on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. They're up against a third and one situation.
Cam Akers does pick it up. We chose which lane we wanted to go to.
For a first down. Give him 2 yards on that play, and it's going to yield a new set of downs.
Well, they're currently the best in the NFL in converting on third down, so it was no surprise.
They're DBs. They just know when I'm passing, and they bring pressure in, like, the worst ways. I had Robert Woods a little bit up the field, but I'm like, going to Cooper Kupp so much.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. And
Man, why does no one get open on that gameplay plan? That is a terrible gameplay plan, I feel like.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free.
Let's call some slants here.
Another incompletion.
Man. Cooper Kupp over the middle. Very nice. Run, Cooper Kupp. That was a nice call with the slants. Oh, man. That was a nice call with the slants.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did.
I'm going to call a deep shot here, man. Just for trolls, man. Just for trolls, because maybe they won't be covering over the middle. I need to stretch it out a little bit. And that's going to be caught by Van Jefferson. Very nice haul in by Van Jefferson. I stuck that in there. I'm not even going to lie. That was a forced throw, but we made it work. We fucking made it work. We're coming down to the two-minute warning.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game.
We're going to attack the zone here. Zone run. See what we can do. Oh, shit. Nice shed off of us. That Shaquille Barrett, we shed it off, man. So that's that does not happen very often.
Recently a member of these Rams with the tackle.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play. Stopped after very
I get it. We're not having a good game running the ball, man. They got to, like, roast me. Oh, Tyler Higbee. Gets a very nice truck off. We'll take that every time with Tyler Higbee there, man.
Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use.
Just gonna go with a run here, try to sneak it in with Cam Akers, because man, their DBs are playing so good. We're not gonna get it.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3 yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
We're gonna run slants again. We got Cooper Kupp, Robert Woods, and Jefferson as options. Hopefully one of them gets open. Kind of want to bleed the clock a little bit just in case we have to kick the three. Don't want to give them time to work the ball and do anything.
Now it's gone.
What? There's no way. Goff with two fumbles.
When I'm watching him play, the one thing that comes to mind is always remember traffic, turbulence, people around you. Two hands. Get two hands on the ball. Grip it tight. I know it looks cool to have it.
And we're going to give up a huge play up. Oh, my Jesus. Oh, man. Goff, please. Please, Goff. We've only allowed 10 rushing yards, man. We need to play some coverage up top. We need to get a safe interception here, man.
Brady now on first down.
And that's going to be batted down by their own player.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap.
They did go for the screenplay there, but we're just playing everything in the sky here. We got John Johnson in zone coverage. I'm going to try to get pressure with Aaron Donald. We were there. Oh my God, we were there. I went for the strip sack. I'm not even gonna lie. I went for the strip sack.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Third and six.
Come on, we need to get pressure in on Brady. Come on. And they double Aaron. And that's gonna be a huge hit from John Johnson, but we do not force the fumble there.
They got 13
seconds to stop the clock. Stop the clock with 13 seconds. We're going to try to bring pressure with Aaron Donald, but it looks like they're going to double him again.
On first down, Brady.
And that's going to be out of bounds. They may kick a field goal here. They may have to kick a field goal.
But they go in the wrong direction. A loss of yards, and now they're dealing with a second and long. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11.
We just got to pray no one gets burned up top, because we've only got one safety up top.
It's Brady.
That's going to be out of bounds. Leonard Floyd almost got there. They may be trying to kick the field goal here.
It's a gain of four.
And they'll need to get to the 35 if they want to keep this drive going on third down.
They got one timeout, so they may attack the middle.
The final shot before half for Brady.
That's going to be knocked down. So we do go into the half tied up at 10. We're going to check the halftime stats. It's been a good game, man. It's been a very even matchup.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome.
No passing TDs. We got 157 air yards. 95 rushing yards compared to their 10. But we do have two fumbles from Goff.
Up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Where it was definitely a game with
we don't really care about what's going on all around the league. Just our quick little half. We do get the ball back. Let's try to put together a nice drive. Hopefully score. We've been having a good defensive game, which I'm very proud of.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25.
You know, we're gonna call our little misdirection here. They're prepared for it. They're calling that linebacker up every time. So I think we may have to stop running this play.
That's for sure, because to be that close and come away with no points is really disappointing, not just for the guys on offense, but the defensive players too, who thought, hey, we're going to put some points up and have a little momentum going. They've got to find a way to just get it out of their minds, let it go, and move on to the next series.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. A shotgun snap for Goff.
That was an easy call right up the middle for Tyler Higbee. They left that wide open. I don't know why they did that.
Mark him down at the 49. A gain there of 21 yards.
One of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Cooper Kupp, we tried to lead him a little bit.
Kupp complete.
But we'll take that.
Yards to pick up there. Cooper Kupp. That is catch number 300 now for his NFL career.
At the 44-yard line.
See if they get baited on the misdirection here. We do call this a lot, but.
Here's Akers.
Doesn't get the spin move off, but he does pick up the first down. We'll take it.
The pickup, first down.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
I'm going to call a little short routes here. Robert Woods up top. We haven't been able to get him very active and involved. So.
On first down, it's gone. And that is incomplete. Van Jefferson was the intended receiver.
Not sure what happened there.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise.
Higbee on a cross route. Robert Woods running a little nice route up top.
On second and 10,
Goff. Incomplete. Robert Woods was open, dude. You got to put a little bit of air behind that, dude. I literally lobbed it.
Well, you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
We're at the 40-yard line. I almost want to run the ball to try to get in field goal range. Man, that was terrible, man. Robert Woods was open with that shot, and Goff just didn't make the throw. Can we get that? And we do get it with Cooper Kupp, and we go dropping down. I feel bad targeting Cooper Kupp all the time, but, man, he's the only person that I can really rely on, like, to catch the ball, to be open on his route.
Already, of course, leading the NFL in receiving yardage.
So he's done nothing at all to hurt his cause to stay in that spot.
Cam Akers, very nice. Over 100 yards now with that pickup.
Call it a gain of 14 for the second play in a row.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive.
I swear I hate these gameplay calls. But I'm going to try it anyway. Tyler Higbee, got to move. Brings it up to the 2-yard line.
They're going to have a first and goal coming up as he's out of bounds at the 2. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down.
We're going to go with a spacing call here. Maybe find Van Jefferson or Robert Woods going up top. If not, throw it away.
From the gun, here's
oh!
To the end zone, but it's
I don't know how he got there. I don't know how he got there.
Brings up second and goal.
And then, oh man, Cam Akers is going to run it in. I just didn't want to risk the passing touchdown because their defense is playing too well. That's going to be his second rushing touchdown, and we are going to take the lead. The running game is what's working. I feel like we need to just pound the ground. That's like maybe our only option there, man, because he's getting yards. I'm tired of going to Cooper Kupp. We need to design some better routes or just get some people on some better routes. That's really what it comes down to.
And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Caught it to 26. At the run, 26-yard line.
I don't know if they're going to run here. But we are going to call a cover one middle blitz. Second
half. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
Good thing he made that tackle, because that would have been a huge run if he broke that out.
Might start to feel like they've got to play catch up here and start matching them point for point, but it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense.
They may be running a screenplay here
to get back in this game.
From the 31, Brady on the crossing route complete. That's Evans. And they get him down.
Very nice find there.
Takes it across the 40-yard line. First down. 11 yards there. First down. First and 10 at the 42-yard line. Working from the gun, it's Brady. And he finds Howard complete.
Oh, Jalen Ramsey just dove the opposite way. And that was a huge play.
Shy of the 20. Big yardage after the catch. That one winds up going for 36.
We're going to fall back into zone coverage because Tom Brady, just they're passing a lot.
They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play.
Taylor Rapp misses the tackle there, and then we allow LeSean McCoy to pick up 8 yards.
And then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
8 yards.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still.
Let's try to get pressure with Aaron Donald here.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every
We'll take that hit from Terrell Burgess. But they are going to come out first and goal, man. They're working the ball up very nicely here. We're going to try to get some pressure here. We dropped him back into coverage. Ah! And D. Will is on Mike Evans. That's not going to work. We may have to swap that out. That was a very nice drive, man. They're showing that they're not to be messed with, man. No matter how hard and long our drives take, that they're going to come back and score. No matter what. And that was a very nice drive put together by the Bucks, man.
To go up and make a play, even when contested, looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
We're not going to return that.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense.
Let's go play action first down.
Like a lock for a 1,000-yard season. Don't know if he's going to get it in this game, but he probably like to just to get past that point.
Yeah, and if he doesn't, as you noted, there's still time, still opportunity. There's still
Holy shit! Was that in bounds?
Yeah, it's not a lock.
Oh, man, it wasn't. Okay, it wasn't in bounds. That was a freaking crazy play there. If that catch had been made, dude, all I can say is, oh my Jesus.
Second and 10, Goff again. And this one incomplete.
Yeah, that was a forced throw there.
To hold on to that one, and it's third down. He did an okay job of absorbing the hit, just couldn't secure the football through the catch.
And he was right there on the spot and forced the incompletion. That's something defenders work on all the time. If you're there,
try to find Robert Woods on his slant route up the middle.
Through the receiver so that he can't possess the football and turn it into a catch.
Fuck, I should have just checked that down. I tried to check that to Henderson, but I just didn't want to get interception there, so I'm going to punt the ball off here.
Stop after the ball hit the ground. I'm giving him some credit.
Well, I'm thinking about the mental focus, you know?
Yeah.
The mental focus.
Yeah, that's true.
Got to stay with it.
That's true. And just a single punt for him in the loss last week as he sends this one away.
Oh, we've got to make that hit with David Long there.
The 35 before going out of bounds. A very good punt, but a 16-yard return. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense.
Here we go. Playing zone D. Gets Tom Brady while he's heating up.
He fakes the give here and looks to throw. That's to his running back, Leonard Fournette. He'll be taken down.
That was my coverage with Troy Reader, but I just couldn't cover him. He's not fast enough.
First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
First and 10 at the 48-yard
line. Need to try to get some pressure with Aaron Donald.
Shotgun now for Brady. That's caught.
Damn.
He is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 30.
They're attacking the middle a lot. Let's go man covers here.
Good for a Buccaneer first to pick up of 12 yards. Now Leonard Fournette. And he'll have a game.
That's going to be a nice run stop there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Gonna go zone coverage again. That was going to be a quick pass up the middle. They're going to come out third and three.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Brady going to try and throw on third down.
That was almost a strip sack by Aaron Donald.
The snuff and coverage there pushes this to fourth down.
And they're going to have to kick a field goal, so we do hold them to three.
An incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him.
Just don't want to rough the kicker. They do get the field goal. They are leading by three coming into the end of the third quarter. I'm hoping we can drive the ball up and score. We're just going to have to keep the ball on the ground. Play the plan. We missed Robert Woods for a huge TD earlier. Still sad about it.
Either way, you got it.
I just went right past it.
Set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. He's up over 100 yards, and he'll be looking to get in the end zone again.
We're going to try to counter this run blitz here. You see it coming. Stretch it to the outside. We do pick up the block. And Cam Akers, oh my Jesus.
He can find that end zone once more. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going.
That is a crazy run by Cam Akers.
Thought they were going to have him down a lot earlier, but he was able to shed that tackle.
Shows the value of the weight room, doesn't it? Shows the value of the attitude when you run the football. Don't go down easily. Break a few tackles, gain some additional yardage.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10.
That's going to be in the pocket.
We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. In the pocket, chucked it away, flag comes down.
And that's going to be a 22-yard penalty, or 12-yard penalty. That sucks. Dude, I don't know what to say there, man. Like, they came in so quick. Just going to try to run here, sneak, pick up something back.
And he's able to get across midfield and down into Buccaneer territory. He's calling a pickup of 7 on the ground. That trims it to a 3rd and 15 situation.
Well, this play sequence was really kind of called in reverse. Incomplete pass on 1st and 10. Nice run on 2nd and 10 when probably everyone was expecting him to throw the football. Now, if you're the defense, would it have been a 2 on 3rd down? You're a little off balance.
That's going to be caught by Cooper Kupp, and he takes a huge hit.
And he is going to have a Rams 1st down.
They did not just give up that 1st down. Let's run another cross route with Van Jefferson.
Some pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy.
That's going to be caught.
Complete here to Jefferson. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it.
So go, Jeff, go. There you go, down to the 3-yard line.
Have a
First and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line.
13 yards. We got Tyler Higbee running all the way across.
Second catch in a row, first down. To the air again. Goff.
Van Jefferson. We put him on a zig route and Van Jefferson burns him. And we get the passing TD. Very nice.
Second touchdown on the season. And the Rams are going to jump back in front.
That was the drive we needed right there. We capped it off with Van Jefferson. That was a very nice audible. Got him on a zag route and
into the receiver's hands even faster.
He just sold. He sold him, man. He sold him.
Up and good, and that will make this a 4-point game.
And Johnny Hecker might boot this through the field goal. That's gonna be a field goal. Johnny Hecker almost a field goal.
And that'll carry
over with that wind. That's like 8 mile per hour wind. That was literally almost a field goal.
Back now comes Tampa Bay.
They want us to play zone coverage here. We're gonna try to get pressure.
They got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want to drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a
They're laying down big hits.
In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative.
Let's go man coverage here.
But you met fan bases that wanted to end, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
That was Ramsey in coverage. We gave it up.
And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40.
I think because I tried to play the receiver there and didn't play the ball at all. That's going to be my bad. We're going to just play Aaron Donald and try to get pressure off the line. Oh, he's always getting doubled. It's going to be a tackle from Jalen Ramsey, but after he picks up about 8 yards, so it wasn't quick enough. We just maybe need to pull out a little bit of man coverage because they are bouncing the ball all the way upfield. Maybe Ebukam can get pressure off the edge.
Let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Brady's throw there complete, and he is tackled.
Troy Reader was in coverage there, and it just wasn't a good play.
15 yards on the play, first down. That time a slant. Brady in general on those quick hitters, he just releases the ball so fast.
He does, and he's so accurate, but most of the time, he wins before the ball's even snapped.
They're moving the ball very well. Don't like this. And that's going to be intercepted by D. Will, and he might take this back for a pick six, and he is because Tom Brady is so slow. Down to the 1 yard line because D. Will decided to flex a little bit. Didn't get the pick six.
Nice return, but you know he's just beating himself up inside for not getting all the way in.
No doubt about it because he had visions of end zone in his mind. Going to be the total hero. But we did see there the emphasis on it's not just good enough to pick it off anymore. Bring it back, get the yardage, and really help out your offense.
That's completely my bad there. And Van Jefferson is going to beat him again on the zig route to get two TDs. That was amazing again. That's kind of why we came down at the one so we can. Oh, that's going
to
be a missed field goal. And we're going to lead by 10. That's not good because we would have lead by two possessions after making that field goal. But that turnover was what we needed. D. Will could have had a pick six and we blew it. I apologize, D. Will. But we did get a passing TD for Jared Goff, so we'll take that.
Let's go get it, and that's exactly what they did.
I think the kickoff power might be a little bit too high. I bumped it to like 55. I think that may be too high.
Tom Brady leads the offense out for their next possession.
So I was trying to do field goal power.
Trailing here in the fourth, he can ill afford a repeat of the interception that ended the last drive.
Yeah, you two scores down. You take it upon yourself now to play perfect or near perfect football.
Ah! And we just got burned. No way. Come on, dude. Come on, bro. First play, really, I'm going to give it up like that. I don't even understand. Like, they may have just called the perfect play there.
Whatever word you want to use in that, man. One play, 75 yards, end zone.
Yeah, efficient, tidy, excellent words. How about explosive? 75 yards, one play. That means everyone handled their assignment, doesn't it? It doesn't just mean that the defense broke down. They really executed the way that was drawn up.
I hate these short kicks, man. They're forcing me to bring it out. Now we're only leading by 3 points, man. That is not good.
set to go again. Here's Cam Akers in the LA offense. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
He's just zipping along today. Everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see a bad
keep the ball on the ground, man.
Have a grin on his face every time his number is called. Because he looks like they're going to be...
And you're going to pick up 9 yards.
Nothing but big-time positive runs.
Making the sideline grin as well.
I'm going to call this play-action double cross here.
And it'll be second down.
Second and a yard.
Did they sell on it? Could bring Tyler Higbee down. And he catches it! Jesus Christ, we brought him down with the throw, and he catches it. That was a beautiful play. Beautiful play. Beautiful throw from Goff. I think we're just going to call. We need to get some backup carries for Daryl Henderson. So I don't like this.
Do me a favor the rest of the way. Sit back, relax, and just appreciate the offensive dominance that's going on out here.
I'll give it a shot.
We're going to take a sack. Daryl Henderson does not get out quick enough.
In there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you got momentum on your
side. Trying to keep it on the ground here. Try to kick the field goal. We need to get back in the field goal range here. That was not good. That sack was not good for us. And we're going to pick up some yards. Dominican Sue has, what the hell kind of reach was that?
Seven on the ground. That trims it to a 3rd and 15 situation.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I may take the check down
with Cooper Kupp and just get into field goal range because, honestly, the rack, he gets there.
And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses.
Oh, they're upset.
That was no 3rd and 2. That was 3rd and 16, but they get the conversion anyway.
They've got to be upset on that one. We may have Shaquille Barrett on the coverage on Higbee. He may get burned there. We had to bring him down with that pass. But we do pick up about 5 yards with Cam Akers.
And really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one.
I might tack over the middle because Van Jefferson is running a long route over the middle. Hot route. Let's put Robert Woods on a slant.
Take your shot at the end zone. To throw again on second down. Goff.
That's going to be caught. What's going on there?
Get there. Tackled down at the 1.
Oh, and they got a roughing the passer call. And that's going to be 1st and goal.
Close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
So the ball's moved to about the 1 after the penalty, 1st and goal. Here's Goff.
Back of the end zone, Cooper Kupp.
That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown.
How could we not take that?
Cooper Kupp.
Oh, no.
Tack on to their advantage.
1st and goal.
It looks like he was in.
Forget establishing anything. Just put it in the
and he made a football move. That's inbounds.
Yeah, I guess that's the definition of catch.
Come on, he made a football move.
They weren't expecting that.
And that totally goes against type, doesn't it? When you think 1st and goal from the 1, you're thinking running play.
And it stands. It stands. Cooper Kupp.
They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for.
And we are going to be back in the lead by 10 points.
Extra point by
very nice drive. That's what we needed after giving up a freaking one play 75-yard touchdown. We're going to kick this awkwardly.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Fielded in the end zone.
He is not going
to
bring that out.
Out
3 minutes left on the clock. I'm expecting them to play Mike Evans, play the pass heavy. The
offensive unit heading back out there now. And I know that they've double teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how
John Johnson. Very nice.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Here's second and seven now from the 28. Operating from the gun, Brady over the middle.
Ah, missed the hit there.
And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well.
Face mask.
It's going to be a face mask.
Come on.
Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now you're.
I think their tackling is aggressive. Yeah, that's why.
Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and ten. From the gun, Brady. That's caught by Howard.
I think that was my coverage there. I don't think I'm going to be able to pick off Brady like that.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made it a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two.
Oh, you've got to make that tackle, Troy Reader. But we do tackle him inbounds. It's going to bring it down to the two-minute warning. They're going to have to try to get a touchdown here and then maybe get the onside kick because
here on EA Sports.
We are still leading by 10 points. I am calling a lot of zone coverage here. Let's just try to get home with Aaron Donald one more time.
First and 10 as they search for a late score. Brady to throw. He's going to have the
quick throw, but we do stop that quickly. Let's bring some pressure in on his ass. What the f-
This is caught. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown.
Come on, dude.
27 yards, and the Bucs are able to make this a close game again.
I don't understand how he was just wide open like that. Now we're only up by 3, and they're most likely going to kick the onside.
Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put
what the hell, and they don't?
Flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20.
Their own 18-yard line.
Yeah, that was ridiculous.
Offense, they
know we're going to run the ball, but
this game not quite
we're still going to run the ball.
We'll likely see him take all three.
Haha, Cam Akers at the middle.
Can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll run this with Akers.
Tried to beat him to the outside, but didn't necessarily get there.
Timeouts, as they'll get it with just under 90 seconds remaining. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. The Bucs with an extra defender now in the secondary here on third down. Now it's gone. Ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They knew we were going to.
From a defensive perspective,
oh man.
Exactly what you want anytime they want to throw the football. There's pressure on the quarterback. They were getting after him, and they tightened down on the receivers and forced the incompletion.
Here's Johnny Hacker now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. He gets us away. It's a good one. Drawing toward the sidelines. And this punt goes out of bounds, and it'll be marked inside the 40.
That was a terrible punt.
So here's Brady and the Bucs. Down by a field goal. 1:16 remaining. And they're in danger of a third straight loss as they come up on first and 10. Now he dumps this off over the middle.
We really need to stop them to a field goal and keep them in bounds.
A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
That's going to fall incomplete.
Incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Incomplete. Brings up second and 10.
Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a second and 10.
I'm going
to
fake the pressure here.
He's back to throw. Throw left side.
Secure the tackle. Inbounds. At the 50-yard line, they got no timeouts.
After a gain of two, maybe three. Throwing is Brady on third down. It drives some people crazy to see those.
That's going to be caught inbounds, and they're going to have to go no huddle here.
Complete to O.J. Howard.
They'll go for it. It's Brady. He's got a man.
No huddle. They're going to lose here. They are unable to spike the ball. We do barely scrape away with the victory against the Bucks by 3 points. Wow. They needed to go to the outside. If they had to went to the outside there, they may have gotten it. We got home a few times on defense with sacks. We got one interception today. Man, that was just a really tough game. We had a really big second half from both of us. 319 air yards, 190 rushing yards, 27 for Tampa Bay, 2 takeaways for Tampa Bay. Both fumbles, no interceptions from Goff, which I'm happy to see. Tampa Bay, man, they're going to go home with Tom Brady shaking his head, and we are going to advance to 8-2. 68% completion ratio from Goff. He is not in the MVP race at all, but he did have a good game, 121.7, 26 for 38, 331 yards, 3 touchdowns, 0 INTs. Brady with a monster game, 405, 3 TDs, 1 INT. Somehow still Brady better than us, because I guess he was 34 for 40. Had a lot better passing. Let's go to the Rams. You know, we're going to check our stats. Cam Akers with a huge game. 24 carries for 183 yards. He is becoming like something that I didn't think. 32-yard run, man. He's just like, I don't know, man. He's a freak of nature. Cooper Kupp, 11 for 158. We really targeted him a lot tonight, but he had only one TD. Van Jefferson, 5 for 45 with 2 TDs. Tyler Higbee, 5 for 90. Robert Woods couldn't find him tonight, 2 for 18. He had one chance for an open shot, and Goff just missed him. Cam Akers went 3 for 20. Defensive, Darius Williams is our star tonight. One interception for a 72-yard return, which could have been a TD, but I messed around a little bit, so I kind of feel bad I took that TD away from him. One sack from Aaron Donald. One sack from Samson Ebukam, and that is going to be it on defense. Punting, 132-yard whack-ass punt. Kick return, all that stuff. I guess that doesn't even really matter. Let's just go ahead and finish the game in advance. Get these last upgrades in. Not what you wanted to see, but I mean, it happens to the best of us, so you know, we led by 3 points like half the game. Throughout the whole game, they really played a good game. That's all we can say, is the Bucks played a really good game. They do fall to 4-7. They're on a losing streak right now. Bryson Hopkins with an upgrade, that's what we like to see. We're gonna give him possession. He is our next man up. Hella upgrades. One awareness, one ball carrier vision, one catching, one lead block, one medium route, one pass block. He just had a ton of upgrades. That's very good. He's pretty quick, 84 speed. Jared Goff with an upgrade. That's what we like to see right there. Jared Goff. We're going to upgrade his improvising. Doesn't get an upgrade, but gets one throw accuracy deep, 2 throw accuracy short, and 2 throw on run. He did throw on the run a lot tonight, so we like that. We like to see that. Dude, I should have done the throwing power, because that's kind of what I wanted to see go up. He's still out for 2 weeks, Joseph Noteboom, but we are going to upgrade him. We need him back. One awareness, two pass block finesse. He's not even good. Johnny Munt can get washed over. Just go ahead and advance to the next week and see what we got going on for next week. No breakout players. No breakout players. That really sucks. We missed our chance with Goff, I think, this year, man. Didn't have any players of the week again. We are still 0-2 in the division. So I don't even think that any of these wins matter. This win against the 49ers is what's really going to matter right here. This is going to be like the most important game we play. I'm not even going to start the training right now. We'll worry about that tomorrow. Free agents. I don't need any free agents right now. They are 5-5, but they did get one of their wins against us. The game planned a lot. The game planned very well. We still are leading the division. The Saints are 9-1 right now. Oh my Jesus. The Chiefs are 7-3. Colts are 7-3. Browns are 7-3. And the Steelers are 7-3. Some pretty good squads, man. Let's check the NFC West. They're all at 5-5. And we're at 8-2. Cardinals are 3-0 in the division. 49ers are 2-1. Seahawks are 1-3. They've got their one win against me. Wow. We have two division losses. So we really gotta clean those up. Check the league stats real quick. First in NFL for passing yards, 12th for touchdowns, and 99.3, 19th NFL for that. Oh, Cam Akers is 1,000 rushing yards, 15 touchdowns, and 211 carries. First in NFL, Cooper Kupp leading the NFL in receiving yards. That's almost too many receiving yards. We're just passing to him too much. We do have the best offense in the league. Only 50 yards, though. The Bucks are right behind us. They're really good. Panthers have a really good rushing offense. 19 passing touchdowns and 20 rushing touchdowns. We're like inflating the stats, I think. We definitely need to get some better passing touchdowns, so maybe we need to start passing the ball more. We are averaging 32 points per game, right up there with the Saints. The Saints are going to be a really good matchup. Right, we're not a top defense in the league anymore. But we are top on that rushing defense, though. We only allowed 700 yards on the ground. Oh, my Jesus. Who's closer? The 49ers had 800. 734 yards on the ground we've allowed. So we play the run really good. Maybe almost too well to where we're giving up the yards in the air because we have 27 air yards allowed. It's not good. We held the freaking Tom Brady to the damn 100 passing yards in the first half, and then he just automatically just exploded. Mike Evans, 9 receptions for 165 yards and 3 reception touchdowns. That's what we allowed to happen to us. I mean, we did come away with the win, but still, man, come on. We have no players of the week. Cam Akers was player of the week last week, or week 8. And Cooper Kupp was player of the week 6. That's all we've got. Damn, we really gave it up. We really gave up that, man. It's alright, though. Team TDs with 12 INTs. That's shitty as hell. We need to up these passing TDs, man. We need to get Jared Goff to like 25 passing TDs. Cam Akers is having just an amazing season, though. 211 carries, 1,000 rushing yards. That's good, man. Cooper Kupp has too many receiving yards. Just look at all my other receivers. This is terrible. I really got to start using everyone else. But it's like he's the only one that gets open half the time, man. I need to draft some better talent, with some faster talent. Van Jefferson is almost playing better than Robert Woods. Like, I'm going to go and find Robert Woods, man. I really need to work on his game, man. Before we lose him, because he's going to be upset and not want to sign with us anymore because he's having a bad season. We got 276 yards, 10 games in. Van Jefferson has 442 yards. Tyler Higbee's going to get a 1,000-yard season before everyone else. We've definitely got to just start feeding the ball to everyone else. Cooper Kupp gets the ball way too much. Maybe we should bench him for a game and see how we do without him. I don't know. Let me know what you think. Maybe we should bench Cooper Kupp for a game or two to see if we can get these other receivers going, man. That might be the play. But until then, we're going to bounce out. It's your boy YRG signing out. Peace.